Hi friends, welcome back to VLSFF, and this video is all about related with the queries of my previous videos, and also we will discuss the current scenarios, scopes and opportunities of the physical design in this video. So first of all, I will be taking all the questions of my previous queries, as I don't get much time to get back to all the queries individually, so I'll be taking all at once. So first question we will discuss, like, from Raj. I have completed electrical engineering. Can I pursue the career? And obviously, so many friends of mine are not from electronics background initially. Initial entrance is important. So after that, only experience would matter actually. Next, Tejashwini. So can you please explain DRCs and power planning? Yes, Tejashwini, definitely. Now I'm making some videos on timing DRCs. Once it is done, I will definitely make videos on others. Next question is from Dipankar Saha. Please make video in skew group balancing. Yes, definitely. I will. I'm making videos right now, but it will take some time actually, as I'm not getting much time. So. Anish, how do you get CDL netlist for LVH check? Okay, you will get it from Foundry itself, and which is like required for V2LVS. Next is Sanjeev. Okay, please update part 3 of 3. Yes, Sanjeev, if you have subscribed my channel, definitely you will get all the videos. Nitin, can you make one video? What is the difference between block level and chip level STA constraints? Sure, I will be uploading, and I have started making videos on timing. It's already, and my next one second. Some A square buddy. We have standard cell library on FF SS. Which library should we use for synthesis? Yes, definitely SS, as we have we are like concerned about the setup only, so the time of synthesis. And lastly, one of my VLSIFF follower from Pakistan, Nasir Khan. NCSU free PDK installation? Yeah, definitely. I will try, Nasir. Once I will get the time, definitely I will try to give some videos on installation of the PDKs also. So how to, now next I will be discussing on how to prepare to get into VLSI industry. So you should have some good knowledge on digital electronics, then microprocessor, computer organization. This is for actually subjective, so like in subject basis you should have some good understanding of the BTech subjects, and knowledge for programming language. You need to learn Verilog, VHDL, and for scripting, Tickle or Perl. And chip design flow and fabrication process also you should be aware of, because when you will get into the lower technology nodes, when you will be clearing some DRCs, you will definitely, you should have a deep understanding of basics of CMOS. Then only you can, you will be aware of how to clean the DRCs, base DRCs, metal DRCs and all. So, and if you have access to the tools, you can use even front end or back end tools, both the tools. So what are the front end tools? Actually, front end tools we use for the logic design, and like Xilinx Vivado is which in which we can write functionality of your design and can check it. So, and the back end tools are, those are sorry, there are so many tools in back end, from Synopsys, Cadence, like DC, ICC2, Genus. So in which you can start with your synthesis and go to the PNR stage, and finally if you have some access on sign off tools also, so you can check for sign off tools also, like Calibre, Prime Time, Red Hawk, these things you can check it if you have access to the tools. Then so now the main question that I'm getting constantly, like how we can enter into the VLSI domain. So like, as now scenario is very tough and competition is very high, so definitely you have to be very much up to date with the things, and you should have good knowledge of all the subjective and you should have good understanding of your Tickle scripting mainly. So like what I'm saying, if you're not getting chance to the domain directly, try to get a referral on and apply off campus. Okay, try to get some referral of the if you have some like a, if you know some person from the company, try to get the referral and do MTech. Like if you are really willing to work on VLSI domain, then try to get the MTech from IITs or some good NITs. Then definitely companies like Intel, Qualcomm, and some big companies do hire from that IITs and NITs. So try to do MTech in VLSI from IITs or good NITs, and you will get into VLSI companies from campus placement. And one second. You can do some industry standard course also as per the company requirement. If you're into verification domain, you can have some UVM, OVM courses. Like some courses are there. I don't know much about that, so I don't want to give comment on that. But in PD, you can have some good courses from, like, at least you should understand the basic PNR flow and the timing fixes, so that you can at least have a good chance to enter into VLSI domain. So like and other things, like join some, if you're not getting chance in good companies like Intel, Qualcomm, or some big huge companies, like, so you try to join some smaller companies, so you may be sent as a contract worker to the bigger VLSI companies, and once you will perform well, maybe that company will opt you. So that is also a way to get into a VLSI domain. And lastly, like if you are really dedicated, like to get entered into VLSI domain, you have to be dedicated first of all, because maybe you will not get a chance in first time itself, so you have to keep on trying. That's the thing. So thank you guys. Okay guys, keep on watching VLSI Fab, and don't forget to comment in the comment box for your suggestion or videos. Please subscribe to my channel VLSI Fab. Thank you.